Hello everyone, this is Purnima Padmanabhan, and today to talk about cloud cost management, I have here with me John McLoughlin.
Thanks, Purnima. Glad to be here.
Great. So let us get into it. I mean, cost and especially cloud spend and cloud cost management has never been a hotter topic than before. It is primarily because over the last few years, many enterprises, many of my customers have actually invested heavily in cloud and infrastructure, and they have built a lot of capacity. But as you know, with the current events and current economic conditions, 2023 truly has become a year where enterprises are looking back into their spend and saying, how can I get the most of what I am spending and how I can optimize it to the best effect? And that trend, of course, extends to cloud cost management. Now, when you think about cloud spend, cloud cost management, and overall spend, it is a very broad topic, and it has many different facets to it. Now, John, prior to joining VMware, was a customer. And so I'd like to turn it over to you, John, and ask you, I mean, how do you think about cloud spend and cloud cost management, both as a customer and now as a vendor?
Well, thanks, Purnima. I do think that, when I was a customer, what we struggled with a lot was translating what was just a raw, billing file, telling you what you spent in cloud environments, hybrid, public, and multi, into something that mattered to your business. So I think where we took the bill was looking at how to contextualize it and then benchmark it against how we're doing both to the metrics of our business, our budget, our costs of goods sold, and then how to optimize it. So what does correct look like within, a given application of your business? And then finally, how do you maintain that optimization so that going forward, you don't keep running into the same hurdles of trying to run an efficient workload? So a lot of what we've been able to do there that I found worked for me in my life as a FinOps practitioner has been to be able to look at each cloud as we're using them, each capability of that cloud, each service, and use those services to align to the applications that are utilizing them to make them successful at understanding what is the impact of using each service against the business impact of the service that you're offering the market.
Your focus was not only providing visibility. And when I say visibility, it is looking at bills, but also looking at an aggregate view of how you're spending across different services, across different teams and different applications. And then it is about how do you benchmark for a given application, for a given team, for a given region, against what is the golden standard? How do you optimize, right? And get the absolute right fit. And optimize doesn't necessarily mean always downsizing. It could also mean right sizing for the business, right? And finally, how do you maintain it on an ongoing basis? Now, of course, these are hard enough when you have just a single environment on-prem or a public cloud. But when you have multi-cloud environments, it becomes even harder. And then when you compound with the fact that it's rarely ever about just optimizing cost as a single vector, but it is optimizing cost in context of all the other vectors so that you get the highest business impact, it makes it very hard.
So building on that, Purnima, you run a large product organization focused on a lot of different disciplines. What happens in your world with that lack of visibility? And what are challenges that customers that you've seen had when they don't get that type of visibility in their environment?
We run a large software organization, and much like the problems that I face are very similar to the problems that my customers face. Rarely do I go to my team and say, just give me a better cost. I want to tell them, hey, it's all about business impact, right? Give me the least possible cost for the performance that I need. I need less than X minutes of late, X seconds, microseconds of latency anywhere my application is accessed from. Or I need geo availabilities across America, APAC, and Europe. So these might be the constraints that I'm giving around cost, but also around performance and security. And so cost is rarely optimized in isolation. It is in service And you're often saying, how can I get the best cost for the performance or the security characteristics or the business characteristics that are needed? And many times in the industry, this part is missed out because there are a lot of tools, but very few solutions that focus on holistically giving you that answer. And to some extent, John, that is where I've been seeing the industry evolve from just cost and spend management to this discipline called FinOps. And I know you've been very engaged in FinOps very early on. Share a little bit more about that.
Yeah, Purnima. I mean, I think the cloud FinOps movement started as an offshoot of the DevOps movement. So it's both a philosophy and a practice. And so you see people who are practitioners of that philosophy, but you also see operators and engineers working together in cloud centers of excellence to be able to drive change through establishing best practices. So it involves a cohort of personas. And then those personas are really focused on giving those best practices back to lines of business to be able to adapt their practices in their development lifecycle to be successful at not just managing for performance or security, but also in ensuring that efficiency that you just mentioned is available. And as you said, no one wants to turn everything off, just to save a dollar. That's not efficient. To be efficient, you have to run the right technologies and at the right capabilities. And you need to understand the business impact of those capabilities against how you're making revenue and margin against it. So really the Cloud FinOps practice is focused on establishing that capability for you to understand the business impact, apply technology best practices across a broad set of personas in operations, engineering, and FinOps.
Yeah. So we went from cloud spend as a small line item, potentially like something that could be just calculated through a tool, to really what is needed is not just a solution, but also a set of best practices on how you have to create an organization to truly drive the discipline of FinOps. And the discipline of FinOps not only takes care of that life cycle that we talked about, but it also requires you to take cost and make it available and visible all the way through shift left. The developers, ideally during the application construction itself, should know the implication of their architectural choices. The pipeline and the owners who are setting up the development pipeline and the DevOps pipeline should know the implication of the number of jobs that they run and where they run and what is the cost impact. And then finally, from an operations and scale out and production perspective, you have to have the implications on how broad the footprint is, how much do you scale, how do you scale out at peak times versus shrink back at less peak times. Those are all key aspects that customers have to think about.
So Purnima, as you mentioned, the cloud FinOps practices are larger, have more influence across more personas than ever before, and this is a growing discipline. What do we feel like in the VMware's approach to cost management that's different?
The first part is, when you look at cost, a lot of times it's about looking at aggregate. It's looking at understanding cost across all environments. So truly, right from get-go, thinking about multi-cloud costing, that also includes on-prem. Because the trade-offs you're making is, do I put an application on-prem or do I put it in the cloud? When do I put it in the cloud? When do I migrate? These questions and what-if analysis and forecasting decisions require you to have a multi-cloud presence. It also has to span the different types of technologies, whether it is PaaS services, Kubernetes, containers, and so on, right? So that is very important. The other piece is, when you think about cost, you want to make sure aligned, think of it as a solution rather than a tool. So what does it mean? We look at the entire life cycle all the way from a lot of work on visibility. Visibility at different levels, to the developer, to the DevOps person, to the CIO, at different levels of visibility. But also, how do you make it easy to benchmark out of the box? How do you make it easy to optimize with out of the box automation capabilities? And how do you make sure that you have policy-based approach to keep it in compliance? So the entire life cycle is the other piece. And then the final piece is, which is probably the closest to my heart, and especially as we launched the broader Aria portfolio last year, and with anchored by Aria, Hub and Graph as a common data source, is never think of cost as an isolated discipline. You are doing cost and you're managing your cost to a particular business objective. And often the business objective is not just cost reduction in isolation, but cost has to be combined with performance and security characteristics. And that is what we are really doing uniquely. Rather than thinking of performance management, security, and cost as multiple disciplines, we are bringing them to a single platform. And not only are we bringing them to a single platform, we are making it available through the entire life cycle of an application through shift left, all the way from app development to app going to production. If you have the right sets of best practices, the right team alignment and org alignment, and the right solution partner, you can go from cost being just a bottom line thing that you optimize for to truly something that can also become a key factor in your revenue, driving your revenue. And that is kind of the whole goal of what we are doing as VMware. Not cost just for finance people, but really cost as a fundamental discipline that goes all the way from app development to DevOps to core operations and to finance and security. What are some of the best practices? I mean, top of the mind, I have one is make sure you create a center of excellence team that is not just about finance, but brings operations, security, as well as your developer and DevOps representative to carve out best practices for cost management.
Yeah, absolutely. I think embracing the philosophy is the first step. And if you don't have people who are engaged in the problem, it's hard to move the needle. I think the second step that we see is make the right thing to do the easy thing to do. And what I mean by that is you have to transparently be able to collect all the necessary metrics and metadata and information about the resources that you're operating and what they cost, so that you can show back to the business where you are. And so I think that's sort of the next big discipline that you start seeing in cloud FinOps.
Yeah, and the next to that would be use that data to create a shared accountability model. Cost can never be driven just by a central ops team. There has to be a shared accountability between the app development teams as well as the operations team. And everybody should have, as you said, with a common view, should also have the ability to do the common optimization actions and day two operations so that you can continuously bring costs down.
Yeah, I think you hit the nail on the head. And frequently what the next thing that our customers end up doing is they're setting up optimization best practices. So moving from just seeing what a chargeback looks like and what someone's spending to knowing what the best value they can generate from their usage is by establishing things like right sizing or reservation or discount optimization or waste reclamation through policy is really how people grow towards seeing the impact of their choices.
Yeah. And the next best practice is, okay, now you have all these optimization recommendations, connect it to two things. Connect it to your business objectives through things like unit economics, as well as connect it to the other operational disciplines, namely, make sure you understand what is the performance characteristics and the security characteristics. So for any environment that you're optimizing, you understand not only cost, but also performance, security, and business impact.
Absolutely. And the final piece is an extension of just what you described, which is, and I just did this with one of our largest customers yesterday, ensure that the whole leadership team is aware of what decisions are being made and how you're actually being successful. Celebrating that success and building a virtuous cycle becomes what makes these practices flourish for a long time inside of businesses.
Oh, very well said. I mean, really, even with my own team, I found when one of the development teams, actually, it was a team that went, had developer, DevOps, operations all coming together, and they presented how they had cut costs by 40% while actually increasing the speed with which they were doing deployments. I mean, that just went viral with the rest of the team. And it then sets a natural, healthy goal within the internal organizations to achieve for more. Hey, John, this has been a great conversation. Thank you.
Thank you, Purnima. Thank you so much.